Hello, hello, welcome back to my channel. Today I want to talk to you about this lot. I have some empties and I'm going to tell you what I emptied, what I thought of the products and if I would repurchase again. And then at the end of the video, I will let you know how much this box was worth and how much I have emptied up until now in a money-wise type of thing. So yeah, just jump into this box of empties and let me tell you what I think of the products. Okay, I am going to start with some random stuff, and that's just some stuff you've seen before. These are the baby wipe type of stuff or cloths I use when I want to remove makeup, or if I'm doing my eye look, I always do my eyes first and I go a little bit out of the rim or go too low with my eyeshadows and I fix it up with this. It's just baby wipes. It doesn't do anything weird to my eyes, but it takes away the makeup I need it, to be taken away. So yeah, this works for me. You've seen it before. I'm not going to go on about them. Same as this one. I always use Kleenex together with the small wet baby cloth type of product because I like to wipe my hands because they're very wet and they so I just use this to make sure that my hands aren't too wet anymore. I have been switching to a tea towel because I think it's a little bit too wasteful to just use only Kleenex. So I've switched to a tea cloth as well, and that's working for me. So maybe you won't be seeing a lot of these anymore. I will always have one, I think, near because it's handy, but I don't want to use one every day because yeah, it's just landfill at the end of the day. And I can use a tea towel, that's perfectly fine. Then something for my contacts. I've emptied this one. It's just contact fluid, so it's not very interesting. I'm going to move on to the next thing. And that's this one. It's from the Chemistry brand. I'm sorry, there's some construction outside of my window. They have been quiet all day, and the moment I started filming, they've been making this noise. So yeah, I'm sorry, I can't really do anything about it. So yeah, we just have to deal with it, I'm sorry. So yeah, this is from the Chemistry brand, that's from Deciem. And Deciem is the same brand that makes The Ordinary skincare products, and this is a inhibitive body serum. And what this does, if you have shaved your legs, armpits, bikini line, anything, and you put this on every day, then the hairs won't grow back as fast as usual. And this does work. It does work. I have used it up almost fully, as you can see, but the thing is this, the stuff that's left, this like apple juice type of color, it's not supposed to be this color. It was just a very light yellowish color when I started it off, and then it's a bit of a hassle to use every day, and I'm not very good at that. I'm not very good at body lotion and stuff like that, so I was not good at doing this, even though it worked. So it got this really weird mahogany color, and I was like, okay, I'm just going to toss it now because I don't think this is good anymore. I think it's past its expiration date. It says that it's going to be good for 12 months after you've opened it, and I think it's not even been that long, but still, you can see why I don't want to use this anymore. I'm not going to repurchase, not because it doesn't work. It works, it's just it doesn't work for me because I am not someone who likes to put, go through that hassle of putting something on my body every day to make sure that my hair stay away. I haven't really figured out another solution for that, but that's going to be fine. I will be good. Then another thing you've already seen on my channel in my empties 1,000 times over. I think there's one in here every month. It's my deodorant. It's a very nice one. There's alcohol in it, so if you don't like that, then please steer clear of this one. But I like it. It works. I only have to use it once. I don't have to bring any deodorant with me. I just really, really like it. Then an empty for my, the first empty I must say, for my Parfumado perfume subscription. I have this subscription on Parfumado. I get a little sample like this. It's 8 mils. And I get to choose what I want every month. And there is also now some makeup and some skincare. And I recently got a little card saying that I've been with them for a year. So, and this was the first one I got from them. So it took me a year to finish this, and that's because I wear perfume every day, but because I... Okay, I'm sorry, I got a phone call, so I'm back. So I was saying that I get a new fragrance every month, and even though I use fragrances every day, 8 mils is kind of a nice amount to get to know the perfume, and they really last, I have to say. And I have had, I think, 12, of course, 12 options, but I think I have 9 for myself, 2 for my husband, and I got, because they have some makeup now, I got this Brow Gel mascara gel type of product to try out. So yeah, so this is the Thierry Mugler Alien Edition. I really like this scent. It's just something I wanted to start off with because I had a lot of samples from this and I really liked it, and I wanted to see if I liked it enough to buy a full size. But you know, because I'm like 1 year in and I've seen how long it takes to finish one of these, because you get a new one every month, I don't think I need to buy a full size of any perfume anymore, so I won't. I just like to use these, and I let my husband pick out some scents for him as well, because, you know, perfume is expensive and I like to just put money like that towards makeup or other stuff, and I think it's fun for my husband to also try some scents out. So yeah, I am really glad I am still on that subscription. Then I am going over into hair care. I have been dabbling into my sample drawer, so you're going to see a lot of sample type of products right now, and this is no exception. This is the Wella Nutri Enrich hair mask, and it's with goji berry. I have no idea what it's going to do, what that does to your hair necessarily. It's a deep nourishing mask. And yeah, I just used it as a mask. I wash my hair, then I leave it in for an hour, and then I rinse it out. And it, yeah, it's nice. It's not as good as the Venus one. I'm really going to repurchase that when I get to my hairdressers. I'm going to my hairdressers this Wednesday, and I'm going to cut my hair. It's going to look real different, so be warned. Yeah, so I think this is a very nice product. It's not as good as the Davinus, but it doesn't, it comes close. Let's put it that way. It comes close. It's made my hair really soft and less fizzy, but also not too heavy. So this is quite a nice, I wouldn't say dupe, but an alternative to the Davinus one, because I think this is going to be way cheaper. It's a drugstore brand, so I think it's going to be way cheaper. So yeah, this is one I would recommend. I won't repurchase because I like the Venus one more, but yeah, it's a nice product. It's nice. I'm also going through my Rituals shampoo. I have like, I don't know, 4 or 5 of these little flasks, and I want to just get rid of it because they're taking up space and I haven't been using it. So I think this was a good time to get rid of them. Also because I want to go back, I think back, yeah, back to a shampoo or conditioner or both from a hairdresser's brand. And I have no clue if I'm going to use the Venus, because I had a sample from the Venus and I didn't really like it. I am thinking of maybe going into Olaplex, but you know, I'm just going to ask my hairdresser for some advice, because I'm just having this dust floating everywhere. Especially because I am going to color my hair again. I want a shampoo that is going to keep the color nice longer. So yeah, I'm going to see if I, you know, find something else. But I wanted to get shot of a lot of these little flasks. And I think I finished one before this. And I have one in my shower at the moment that is also almost gone. So yeah, I'm doing good on those. For repurchasing reasons, I think it's a good one, but I think it's a bit expensive for what it is. You can just get a drugstore brand and it does the same for you. So yeah, that's up to you, really. It smells really nice. That's the thing. It really does smell very nice. Same thing with this Aussie shampoo, Mega shampoo. It's for everyday cleaning. That's not so everyday. Okay, well, whatever. There's kangaroo paw and flower extract in here, they say. I think kangaroo paw. I hope it's a plant and it's not it's probably not from a kangaroo, live kangaroo. But yeah. I won't say that I didn't like it, but I didn't like it. It stripped my hair. So the thing is, it's not like I noticed the effect when my hair was dry and I blow dried my hair, it was fine. But the moment you step out of the shower, if you haven't conditioned your hair, it's all squeaky feeling. So I won't repurchase this at all. I bought this little one because I wanted to have something when I was traveling. So I think it's a nice size for traveling, especially when you go like a week or maybe 2 weeks or maybe 3 or 4, because I wash my hair maybe once, sometimes 2 times a week. And yeah, I wouldn't really recommend because of that squeaky feel. And I have a lot of shampoos. I tried a lot of shampoos that are, you know, better in that. They don't do that. So yeah, for me, it's not a favorite. So yeah. Then I want to go into some skincare. I have finished this Biodermal Anti-Age Night Cream. I really like this night cream. I just switched to more of the samples because I want to try something else. I think I need something richer. This is just a nice moisturizing type of night cream, and it's not necessarily doing something special for my skin. And I have been trying some other products in sample sizes that, you know, do more for my skin, so I want to switch. So this is probably the last time you're going to see this one. I've been using this for years and it has been enough for years, but I'm like 36 right now, and this is for 25 plus, so I need to, you know, ramp it up a bit. So yeah, this is I think the last time you will see this bottle. And I don't know what to use next, so if you have any tips, then just leave them down below. What I have been using that I really, really liked is this Re-Nutriv Night. I think it's not necessarily a night cream, it's just I use it as a night cream. It's the Ultimate Renewal Nourishing Radiance Cream, and it came in this little sample size. And it smells really nice, but really, really perfumey. So I can imagine if you don't like perfume in your skincare that you wouldn't like this one. I have used this. It's quite a decent size also. It's not, if you can see, it's not too bright. Yeah, I think you can see. It's quite a nice size to really try this product out. So I have been using this consistently. And in the beginning I was like, okay, I know this must be a very expensive cream because, you know, it's Estee Lauder. So it's quite an expensive skincare brand. Or their skincare is quite expensive. And I was like, okay, I don't really notice something right away, but using it over and over and over, I really noticed that my skin was getting really like soft and plump and more hydrated. So this really did something. And I think I'm going to see if I can get the full size maybe during the sale, of course, because seriously, this is really expensive. And here in Holland, somehow, Estee Lauder is always on sale. There's always someone having it on sale. So I'm going to try if I'm going to see if I can find a full size that is on sale and it's not extremely expensive, because I'm not going to lay down like $80 for a skincare or a moisturizer or a night cream. But this was really, really nice. Really nice. I've also finished this little Clinique All About Eyes cream. And this is something I am really indifferent about. I liked it. It's not a bad product. It doesn't really smell. No, it doesn't really have a scent. The Moisture Surge creams really smell bad, in my opinion. This didn't have a smell at all. It was nice. It hydrated my skin. It was a nice, you know, just the eye cream. Did nothing major. Did nothing special. It was okay. It just okay. Okay product for me. I have been using other eye creams I like more. So yeah, this is just empty and it's a nice little pot. I think I'm going to save both of these because I can take them traveling. Just fill them up with something I do enjoy using and then take them traveling. So I'm not going to throw them away. But I didn't really think this is such a great product. Then this is also an empty. This is a empty for the long tube type of packaging. I think it was in last month's empty, or maybe in the month before. It's the Moisture Surge Hydrating Supercharged Concentrate from Clinique, and it's the gel type consistency, and I really like this for summer. And I found it in my sample drawer, so I wanted to just finish it off because it's teeny tiny. I think I took like one, no, not one, I think two, maybe 3 weeks to finish this. But that was because I was also mixing it with something else, so I didn't use a lot. It's a nice product. I've talked about it in my previous video, so if you want to see what I think, then please look it up. If I can find which one it was, I will link it down in the description box. But yeah, it's a fine product. It's okay. It's okay. Then this micellar water from Garnier. I really, really love this micellar water. I am currently using one from, I think it's Niobe. I have no idea. It's a really weird name. It came in one of my beauty boxes, so I wanted to try it. That's also one of my little missions at the moment, to use the stuff I got in my beauty boxes, because it's fun to get a beauty box, but if you don't use the products, it's just a waste of money. So yeah, I have been finishing this. I love this. I'm working on another one at the moment. And I can already tell you, I like this more. And I think I have one or two backups in my drawers at the moment. So if that one finishes, I'm just going to switch back to this one. Another little sample that came in one of my subscription boxes. Okay, English grammar thing. Yeah, that is this Balance Seam Natural Skincare, and it's a vitamin C repair serum with hyaluronic acid. I really like this. This instantly, the moment it sank into my skin, made my skin feel way more hydrated, plumper, and it smells really nice. I think everything with vitamin C in it, it has such a fresh scent. I am at the moment using as a day cream the ginseng cream by, I think it's Origins. I love that also. It has this really nice vitamin C citrusy smell to it. And it's really, really nice to wake up to, really, because it's invigorating right out the gate. So yeah, I really like this. I have no clue where to get it. I think it looked fantastic because I think I got it in a Look Fantastic box. So I might repurchase this one, but I'm also working on the Origins, and I really like the Origins. I don't know. It's just something I would think you can get safely. No, I think I would recommend it. Maybe you can try a sample of these. I don't know if you can get samples from Look Fantastic, but if you can, then I would try it before, because you know, buying a full size before you know if you're going to react to something or not, because I think vitamin C can be a bit harsh on your skin. Harsh on your skin. Dang. Talking is sometimes. So yeah, I think you can, if you can get a sample of this, then it would be a nice thing to try out. I really liked it. Then I'm going into makeup. I don't have a lot of makeup stuff. It's the last stuff I have. This happened. Look, I hope you can see. Maybe I should do it like this. No, I hope you can see, but open up, please. This is a Tweezerman curler, and I hope you can see that this just broke off. This thing is $35. I don't even have it for 1 year, and it already broke. And the thing is, I really liked it. It worked a charm, but I'm not going to repurchase this, because seriously, $35 and then this happens? I'm sorry, it can't happen. I'm sorry, this is, no. So that's the thing. Then I have finished my first Monsieur Big mascara by Lancôme. I love this mascara. This is a mascara I bought because Charlotte Holdcroft is like, it's her holy grail, and I really wanted to try it. I got it on a sale, and I am definitely repurchasing. I'm especially repurchasing this during the holidays, because 9 out of 10 times you can find a pack of these. You can get a beautiful discount on them. So yeah, I really, really, really love this mascara, and I'm going to get it again. And this is the last thing. This is an eye foundation by Catrice. If you have been watching my Project Pen video, then you've known that I've throw this, just called it done. because I hate how it is right now. The product is not really for me because I don't really like this. There's not very a lot of pigment in the product, so you don't get a lot of coverage on your eye, and I like to cover the veins and the darkness on my eyes before I put on eyeshadow. This doesn't really do that. It has the same type of consistency as the Urban Decay Anti-Age thing, or I only had the Anti-Age primer. I didn't like that also. So the thing was, I just put this on and then I put my normal MAC paint pump over it because I just wanted to empty it, and that is something I'm not going to do anymore, but you know, that was a thing when I started this. Yeah, like I said, it wasn't a very bad product, it just isn't for me, and I'm tossing it because the stopper fell out, so I tried to use it, but now it does. When I take out the wand, it gets all gloppy and gross, and then this on the sides gets gross, and that gets into other products. It's a whole thing, so I don't want to do that anymore. So I'm just tossing it. It's an empty for me. It's done. And guys, that's it for me for my empties this month. It wasn't a lot, but that's a good thing because I think last month was huge because it was an accumulation of like 2 or 3 months combined. So this is just, I think, a very normal amount of empties to have in a month. I'm going to let you know what the amount is. I'm going to put it up here, what I have been emptying out this month, so the total amount of the products you've seen in this video, and this is the amount I have been emptying throughout the year. I haven't accumulated all the products, I have just thrown them away, so I'm not going to do a end of year empties type of thing. I might do some sort of a roundup at the December one. I'll figure it out and you will see it here on my channel. Please, if you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you will subscribe, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!